A hiker in New Hampshire is taking on some serious mileage with an unconventional hiking partner. News Center Maine's photojournalist Jake Richards introduces us.
Like when we're in the woods and we're going, she loves to be on the trail. Sometimes when we're on like ridgelines or we're above tree line, if it's really windy, she definitely prefers the pack.
There you go.
So I am Mel Elam and this is Floki. Today we are going to go up Mount Adams. We're working on my best friend Michaela's 48.
All right, there you go, folks. And she's in.
The New Hampshire 4,000 footers, so it's all of the summits that are higher than 4,000 feet. We completed the 48. Floki's completed her 48.
You trust me way too much.
Well, I had seen back in 2014 a gentleman when I did my first 4,000 footer, which was Mount Washington, and he was hiking with his cat, and I thought it was the coolest thing. So I thought to myself, well, why not? Like, if he could hike with his cat, maybe I can.
What do you see, folks?
So the first time I put the harness on her and then the lead, she did that typical cat alligator roll is what I call it. And I'm sure other cat owners who have tried this can, you know, understand where I'm coming from. But once she had it on and she was okay, and I brought her outside into like the high grass in my yard, she just was like, oh, this isn't so bad. And just started exploring and she didn't even notice it anymore.
So when people ask, you know, what's it like to hike with your cat or what do you recommend? I always say patience, because as you can see,
she really seems to enjoy the sights and the sounds, like especially once we're on the trail away from like the traffic and the noise and stuff. And she really enjoys like the birds and she's always looking up at them. And everyone's always like, oh my goodness, you're hiking with a cat.
Too many hiking cats
nope,
on this trail.
You don't.
Cool.
Like everybody just seems to love her. When I first started hiking with her, it was actually Musilaki was her first summit. And we met a hiker coming down and she noticed Floki and was like, oh my goodness, like what's her tag? And I was like, I don't know what that means because I am not good with that kind of stuff. And she's like, no, her Instagram tag, like, what is it? I'm like, oh, I said, I don't have one for her. So she's like, well, we're gonna fix that. And so Adventures with Floki Cat came up and we just started doing that. And then eventually she just started getting followed by all these people. I had friends that would share it and it just kind of grew from there. So I'm like, well, if you know this is happening, then I might as well try to make good come out of it. We did Seek the Peak last weekend, and it's a fundraiser for the Mount Washington Observatory. A lot of the hikers in the area use the observatory's higher summit forecast to be able to check what it's going to be like there to help protect ourselves and keep us safe. And they do a lot of educational programs, and it's a really great fundraising opportunity for them. And they strictly run off of like donations, so it was really fantastic to be able to be a part of that and to use her social media presence to help.
Wow, seeing a lot more of the world than most cats. Mel and Floki raised over $3,000 for Seek the Peak.